Hello, welcome to the Calumet Wilderness with Sam Love. I am your host, Sam Love, and as you can see, it snowed a bit in the Calumet Wilderness, so let's do some indoor pursuits today. I mentioned this back in episode 50, the Indiana Historical Aerial Photograph Index. This is a fantastic source that I learned about during the Calumet Stewardship Initiative in 2015. So what I want to do here is give a brief overview, a basic primer on using this resource, and then give a few time-lapse images at the end. I'll put the link below, but really the easiest thing to do is just go to your favorite search engine and type in IHAPI. That will take you to the IHAPI overview page, which is hosted by Indiana University, the Indiana Geological and Water Survey. So IHAPI is an index of over 100,000 black and white aerial photos that were made of the state from the late 1930s to the early 1970s. Most of the page is organized to help people locate a specific photograph and then go find the actual physical image to study. But for our purposes, you know, these fairly low-res scans are useful enough. So it's a great source if you want to see how natural areas have changed over time, or residential areas, highways, industrial areas, or if you just want to see what your neighborhood looked like 50 years ago, 60, 70 years ago, it's a great source. All right, so here's some basic page orientation. On the left, you have layers, and we'll look at these reference features. These can be really helpful in getting yourself oriented, because these images can be somewhat, not only low res, but somewhat unfamiliar. You also have this. I'll get to that in just a second. Moving on over, you see we've got, you can control scale. There's an address bar up at the top. And then most helpful are the navigation toolbar here. So you can start by selecting county, and we'll do my county, Lake County. And you see how slow my computer is. It'll give you the first year available, 1939. So you see these green dots. So you can click that photo ID points thing there, and that'll get rid of those. That just shows where the center of the photograph is, and I find it really distracting. Also, you can see what selections we have for Lake County. We've got 1939, we've got two in the 50s, 1965, and then it concludes in 1973. So really important time in the growth and development of Northwest Indiana. So what I'm going to do here is just going to type in the zip code for Miller, my neighborhood, and show you the results. Click on that, it'll highlight it and zoom it right in for you. And again, you can see how slow my computer is. Oh, there it goes. And there you have Miller in 1939. You can see the demarcation to the left of the dune and swale, and then to the right, the nonlinear dunes. You can see that the residential area is just the first few blocks by the lake and then the old part of town. And here in 1954, you can see a little more residential development. Let's move ahead to 1958. Again, you can clearly see the pattern starting to fill in there closer to the beach. Mid-60s, you can, of course, see all the development even south down to Lake Station, which was East Gary at the time. And you can just see how little by little those natural areas kind of got chipped away until they finally said enough and brought the Miller Beach, Miller Woods area into the National Lakeshore. If you zoom in too much, it's just a pixelated mess, but this is a great overview, enough to get a generality. You know, is an area a woodland, or is it a wetland? Is it a prairie, residential subdivision, etc.? It's good for that. All right, so here we have my old neighborhood in 1939, Howard Island, or North Merrillville, and we can tell at this scale it's pretty blurry, so let's zoom out a little better. But still, there really aren't too many recognizable features here. I mean, I can see Broadway to the left, and that line running left to right, that's a fold in the map or in the photographs. So you can kind of make out a bit of Glen Park to the north, but not much familiar to the south until we click on highways and roads. And there we get a rough approximation. They're not quite perfectly aligned, but again, this is a good source to kind of just get a general overview. So I'm going to zoom in just a little bit here to get a sense of what my old part of town would have looked like back then. So you can see My Old Block was wooded. You can see that the Georgia Heights neighborhood isn't there. It looks like it's mostly farm fields. We jump ahead to the early 50s, and again, still wooded in my part. And you can start to see some of those first brick homes coming in around Georgia Heights in that community. Let's go ahead a few years. That noise is my cat. All right, took care of that distraction. You can see late 50s, neighborhood starting to take shape, more homes. We moved to the mid-60s, and pretty much looks like the neighborhood that I was born into there. All those fields are gone. Let's check out the late 70s. The film quality really ebbs and flows over the years, and you can notice on this one you have identification numbers right over the neighborhood. Well, let's do one more. Here we have the I-65 Route 30 corridor in Merrillville in 1973, and here we have it in 1939. Almost unrecognizable. It's just fields. You can see Broadway and Taft Street. Here, I'll put the reference points on so you can see 53 is Broadway and 55 is Taft/Main Street. Zoom in a bit more and just fields. Like, I remember all the old timers talking about. Actually, I remember my mother saying I shouldn't call her an old timer, should I? Here it is in 1958. You can see in the upper right corner some subdivision development. Also along 55, some homes going in. And let's jump to the mid-60s. You can see that the reference lines for the streets don't necessarily line up. Again, they're just reference points. The scales are a little different. They were doing these for moving airplanes, for heaven's sakes. And here we are in 1973. Still fairly rural along 30, but developing. This is a little ahead of time here, but I actually remember as a kid when there was nothing from Colorado Street to Toys R Us. We had to drive through that field to get to that little slice of heaven there. So that is the Indiana Historical Aerial Photo Index. I hope you find that useful. What did your neighborhood look like before it was a neighborhood? Let me know in the comments. If you haven't already, please click that subscribe button. Thank you if you already have. And I'll be back with another adventure in the Calumet Wilderness. Maybe I'll be outside. Maybe I'll be inside. Who knows? But take care and appreciate your landscape.